Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. Welcome to another video on Jetpack Compose. And in this video, we will learn about building the UI, which looks something like this. Well, if you pay attention to the closer detail, actually you have a shadow for this particular card that is something like this. Now, how are we going to build this particular UI? Well, it is very easy to get tempted to get into coding mode immediately. But what I would suggest is avoid the temptation to code immediately. Rather than doing the coding, spend some time trying to understand how these various UI elements in this particular card might have been arranged. So if you put more time trying to analyze this aspect of this particular UI element arrangement, then you may come up with this simple understanding. So what we basically have is a large card area, and that card area is basically subdivided into various other sections. For example, you have initial 20% of the card, which contains flag, the common name of the country, and the capital. And then in the remaining 80% of the region, you have multiple subsections like the official name of the country, the region, the sub-region. And then under that, you have another whole row which is subdivided into currency symbol, element to display the currency name. And then the last part of the section is divided into a telephone prefix and the top level domain. That is, in case of India, it would be .in, in case of US, .us, something like that. So this is how our overall layout of the card looks like. And of course, that card has shadow. Well, to be able to successfully build this particular UI, you should be familiar with various concepts like layout, row, image, surface, material design, modifiers, things like canvas, alignment, and arrangement. To some extent, we have seen it in the very initial couple of videos, but we have not explored it in a very full-fledged manner. So in the next couple of videos, it's all about basics of building the UI using Jetpack Compose, that is composable. So without wasting much time, let's get into a demo. So I have already created an application called as Country Info App. It doesn't contain much. It just contains a main activity. Right now, it contains nothing. It is empty. What I have also done is I have already taken care of adding appropriate dependencies that I need for the Jetpack Compose, that is all these compose related dependencies. So once that is done, we are all set for implementing the UI. So the starting point is we need to have a screen. So let me start by adding the screen. And how do I do that? Composable. And under the composable, I will write a function. Let me call it as main screen. And under the main screen, you can write country info app theme. If you are wondering what is this country info app theme, it is once again a theme that gets created by default when you create your application. So it is basically defined here in the theme.kt. There are certain advantages of putting your composables under this particular theme. Even this particular theme is a composable at the end of the day. We will be exploring theme later in a detailed manner, but just for simplicity purpose, think that themes are basically used to achieve consistent UI look and feel across the application. So having understood that, I have used that particular theme. Nothing complicated so far. But under this, what we will do is we will create a surface, and I want to basically make sure that this surface occupies the whole screen. So to do that, what I will do is I will add modifier dot. There are various options, but what I am interested in is dot fill max size. So I want this particular surface to basically take the maximum size available on the screen. And then I also want to decide what color it needs to have. You can choose color like this, but rather than that, I will use material theme. Once again, material theme is part of the material UI that is part of the Jetpack Compose. So I am using that material theme.colorscheme.surface. Let me call this main screen here under the set content and also under here the preview, and you should be able to see what we are getting here. And under this color scheme, there are various options that you can use. That is surface, background, error, primary. So material theme already comes with various colors for different things. In this case, for surface, I am using white color because that is what it is by default assigned with. So this is our surface. And under this particular surface, I want to basically add my card. So let me create composable called as country card, and under that let me create a surface. And this surface is similar to the surface that we have created here, but this surface is basically being used to render the card. Think of surface as a basic canvas or a region on which you can put many other UI components. You might be having a question, then why can't I use simple row or column? Well, there are certain advantages with the surface because surface works very well with the default theming of the application, and you can also provide the elevation, shadow, those kind of features. And that is the reason why we want to use this surface. So what we will do is we will add once again modifier to that, and I want to basically take the maximum width that is available. So fill maximum width, I don't want to use the fill maximum size, that will occupy the whole screen, and also I don't want to occupy the whole height. The most suited one is this one, and here you can give what percentage of the width you want to occupy. 1.0 is the full width, but if you want to set some 60%, 70%, then you will be giving 0.6, 0.7, like that. In this case, I want to go the full width, so I would be writing 1.0f, and then I want to have a padding of say 10 dp. This is how you give the density independent pixel values. And the height, I don't want to decide what height I want it to be right now. Depending upon how many elements that I keep adding inside this particular country card, the height should wrap around those elements. So that is the reason why I am using this particular wrap content height. And then I want to align at the top, say alignment dot top. Let me just put it in a way that it becomes easily readable. And then I also want to add some kind of a border. So I would say border 1 dp. So the border line should be of 1 dp width. And you can decide the color. Color would be color dot light gray. And this should be good enough. Let me add some text here right now, just for testing purpose. And let me render this card. Inside this, you can see that this is how it looks. Zoom in, this is the border with the gray color that you are getting. But also we need to get a shadow to this particular card. So that brings us
to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care, bye.